Inside Science.
Heat is actually the number one weather-related cause of death in the United States, more than tornadoes, more than hurricanes, floods, or cold temperatures. And it's something that we expect to become worse as climate change causes our daily temperatures to rise. So we were interested in understanding how the public perceives the risk of extreme heat events or heat waves. I'm a social scientist. I'm a geographer by training, and I'm interested in how people think about and respond to climate change and hazards related to climate change. Using social surveys, we can get a pretty good picture at, say, the national level on what the public thinks about risks or what sorts of policies they might support or how they understand particular issues. So places with hotter climates, as you might expect, tend to have the highest heat-related mortality and illness. Places like Arizona, Nevada, Texas, California. And we also see higher risks in urban areas as well, and especially among elderly people. Communication is something that we need to work on and target resources towards reducing risks among these groups. I think in some cases we develop expectations about what the weather should be like in places where we live based on our experience. And as we are seeing the climate change, the weather conditions that we're likely to experience in our local areas are going to become more extreme. We should be updating our expectations about what we think, what we will be experiencing, and part of that involves listening to forecasters.
Inside Science. If you enjoyed this edition, follow us on the web and social media. Powered by the American Institute of Physics and a coalition of underwriters.